Hello everyone, this is Sridevi, faculty in Thala Padmavati International School, Warangal. Today, we are going to learn a new topic from grade 8, geography, that is resources. Resources are nothing but supply of something from which a benefit is produced and that has more utility. According to geography, person must understand that a resource is a cultural concept. A resource is any physical material constituting part of earth that people need and value. And the most important to know and understand is that natural material, because a resource when humans value them. Let us go deep into the topic about source and resource. We can see on the screen the meaning of source. The main thing from which a resource is made. Example, cotton. Children, you know very well, out of cotton we make clothes. And here, when cotton is converted into clothes, it is a support of a resource where the source is used to make a resource. And for the better understanding, resource is nothing but anything that can be used to satisfy a need. So here I hope you understand, cotton is being converted into cloth so that we can satisfy our need. And in the same way, resource is nothing but to satisfy the need. They have given an example. We use a rickshaw to reach home. So rickshaw is a support where in time helps us to reach our home. So it is being used as a resource. You can see the example, source, the jute plantations on the screen, you can see on the image, and the source of jute plantations converting into a resource where we can use the jute in many ways like carpets, bags, etc. And in the same way, a river in the below image, where a river water turning into tap water. River water is a source where a facility is being created by nature and it got its value unless and until it is being filtered and supplied into our home. So it is being used step after the step as a jute plantations were in the form of source were turned up to resource after the completion of it, a natural material which was being converted into a usable thing where human ideas have created such things. So in this way, when we go next to the topic, utility, value and economical value, these are the characteristics of resources. So let us know about the characteristics of resources, that is utility. Example, I want to say you, water, electricity, rickshaw, vegetable, these are something in common. They have all been used by you all. So they have utility. Utility or usability is what makes an object or substance a resource. Here the thing to understand is, it is according to the use. Utility is nothing but it depends on usability according to the need. So which a utility is nothing but usability which makes us to utilize either the object or the substance according to our need. In the same way, when we talk about value, value is nothing but it is a resource which can be paid. Example, a value means something like which can be paid, I can say you an example, Some resources have economic value, which makes a materialistic. Like, for example, you buy a chocolate or biscuit into the market, out of a market, and satisfy your need. Unless or until you pay it, you can't satisfy yourself. So here, value is nothing but, according to the situation, it can be turned when it is been paid. Example is, one more example I want to say you is like, example your grandmother. If your grandmother supports a remedies, homely remedies for health, if she want to give some homely remedies, it's a common thing where grandparents give us ideas, not to eat this, if you feel stomachache, or eat something like, or drink some hot water, something sort of ideas will be given by them. They don't have any value because they are free of cost. It is the idea given by grandmother, and it is will or wish of us, if we use or not, it doesn't matter. Whereas such ideas which are being converted into a medical assert and made into a product and sold in the market, obviously the idea which was being extracted or given by your grandma is paid in the market in the form of medicine. When it has been made in the form of a medicine, it has got its economical value. I hope you understood the characteristics of resources. Utility, it is a basic need according to the time and period that is based on object and substance. And value is nothing but according to the situation. Sometimes it got its value by nature, we may not pay. For example, air. In the same way, air cannot be paid. Why? Because it is a natural resource. Whereas water, when it is in the river, it doesn't have any value. When we purchase them, it got its economical value. This is what about characteristics of resources. Now, let us go to the next. And now, let us learn about resources. Resources are of three classification. Resources are being classified into three: natural, human-made, and human. What are natural resources? I hope you all know very well, but still, nothing but natural resources are that which we get from nature. Resources that are drawn from nature and used without much modification are called as natural resources. The air we breathe, the water in our rivers and lakes, the soil, minerals are all natural resources. Many of these resources are free gift of nature and can be used directly. In some cases, tools and technology may be needed to use a natural resource into the best possible way. So you can see natural resources which are drawn from nature. Many of the resources are free gift of nature and can be used directly. And based on technology, they are being used according to the need. And natural resources are classified into different groups depending upon their level of development, use, origin, stock and distribution. You can see in the image, natural resources are again classified into different groups. You can see the four groups here: level of development and use, origin, stock and distribution. On the basis of their development and use, resources can be classified into two groups: actual resources and potential resources. Let us see about level of development, which is being classified into two, that is actual resources and potential resources. What are these actual resources? Actual resources are those resources whose quantity is known. These resources are being used in the present. You can see the rich deposit of coal. These resources are being used in present. like you are taking the best example of coal, where whose quantity is known. We know that the quantity of coal present is limited or huge or unlimited. According to its presence or according to its quantity, we can call it as actual resource. Like the rich deposits of the, not only the rich deposits of coal, even the petroleum. They have been having the same demand, even though they either increase or decrease, less in quantity or more in quantity. But they are being called as actual resources. Whereas potential resources are those whose entire quantity may not be known and there are not being used. You can see there in the image, high speed winds were a potential resource 200 years ago. The best example for potential resource is windmills. Once upon a time, people don't have any idea or the capability or the usage of windmills, which were not in advance to generate electricity in those days. But now, most of the countries have adopted the method of extracting energy through windmills. So, once upon a time it was a potential energy, potential resource, but now it has become one of the part of actual resource as its usage has been continued and improved more. So, potential resources are those resources which could be used in the future, and based on the technology they may come up and their usage will be more and more even in future. Even solar energy, hydel energy. Yes, in the continuation of the topic, let us go to the next about origin, that is biotic and abiotic. Based on their origin, abiotic resources are non-living things. Non-living things, of course, you know very well. Example for non-living things is rocks, minerals, soils, etc. And biotic resources are living things like plants and animals. And natural resources are again broadly categorized into two, that is renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources are those which can get renewed or replenished quickly. Some of these are unlimited and are not affected by human activities, such as solar and wind energy. The best example of this is solar energy, wind energy, even certain renewable resources. We can take examples as water, soil, forest. But still, it is a part of human responsibility to use these renewable resources, which are unlimited, for their comfortable life in future. Renewable resources non-renewable resources. Let us know about non-renewable resources. Resources which cannot be renewed or replenished. Once they are being used, which cannot be given back immediately or get back immediately. Once the stock is exhausted, it takes thousands of years to be renewed. In the same way as we heard in the renewable, once the solar energy is being extracted from sun, it is for sure that until the earth is there, the sun is there. So the extraction of solar energy will be renewed continuously throughout the end of this planet. Whereas non-renewable, once they are being used, once the petroleum is extracted from the interior part of the ocean bed, once they are being utilized as a fuel, it has been exhausted. The exact fuel cannot be made. If in case to make that petroleum, it takes thousands of years time period to get back that resource. So this is what about renewable and non-renewable resources. Let us go into the next. You can see the best examples of renewable resources: solar energy, water and wind, which are being considered as renewable resources. And here you can see non-renewable resources: phosphate, oil and limestone, which are being extracted. And after their use, it is not that easy to make, where the solar energy can be made from the sun, from the heat which has been released from the sun. Whereas non-renewable, they will be exhausted and it takes longer period of time to make them back again. Let us go to the next topic, that is distribution. Distribution of resources are of again two: ubiquitous and localized resources. Based on distribution, resources are of ubiquitous and localized. Resources that are found everywhere, like air, let us take the example of air, they are being considered as ubiquitous. Whereas localized, resources that are found in certain place, everywhere we can't find copper mines or iron mines, they got certain places to find such type of mineral wealth. So where they are not found all over the places, everywhere, they are called as localized. Whereas ubiquitous are nothing but they are everywhere. And next, the distribution of natural resources depends upon number of physical factors like terrain, climate and altitude. Of course, it is true. Natural resources are not the same and not the same in quantity in all the places. They are based on different factors like terrain, climatic conditions, altitude, that is mountains, plains, valleys. And even the distribution of natural resources is unequal because these factors differ so much over the earth, as the earth is not even in all the places. And it's not the creation that every natural resource is to be presented all over the place. So it is being distributed uneven in all places in different ways. Human-made resources. One of the other interesting topic regarding this lesson is human-made resources. What are human-made resources? Something natural substance become resource only when their original form has been changed. Iron ore was not a resource until people learned to extract iron from it. People use natural resource to make buildings, bridges, roads, machinery and vehicles, which are known as human-made resources. So based on these oil extraction, technology is the most important thing, or the assert of human being to show his innovative idea to produce a resource out of a natural product. Human resource. People are human resources. Education and health help in making people a valuable resource. So human itself are being considered as a resource. People make the best use of nature to create more resources when they have the knowledge, skill and the technology to do so. That is why human beings are a special resource. People are human resource because education and health help in making people a valuable resources. Improving the quality of people's skill so that they are been to create more resources to know the human resource development. Let us go to the continuation of the topic. Conservation of resources. What is this conservation of resources? Using resources carefully and giving them time to get renewed is called conserving resources. Balancing the need to use resources and also conserve them for the future is called sustainable resources. sustainable resource is nothing but we have to utilize the resources carefully so that beside meeting the requirements of the present also takes care of future generations. It is a part of every individual responsibility to protect and preserve the resources for the future generations where they need to use them and pass over to the next generations. So each person can contribute by reducing consumption, recycling and reusing things. Ultimately, it makes a difference because all our lives are linked. The future of our planets and its people is linked with our ability to maintain and preserve the life support system that nature provides. Therefore, it's our duty to ensure that all uses of renewable resources are sustainable. The diversity of life on the earth is conserved. The damage to natural environment system is minimized. So it is our basic responsibility to think over and protect our nature, help our Mother Earth to preserve its sources, resources, and generate and give for the future generations. I hope you all enjoyed the topic. Thank you. Stay safe, stay home.